We have a new video in which Tesla Cybertruck shows electric slide on the ice. Welcome back, everyone. Yesterday, we brought you the incredible video footage of Tesla's revolutionary Cybertruck being put through its paces during rigorous testing in New Zealand. But the excitement didn't end there. Following the initial phase of testing, the Cybertruck embarked on its second phase during taking on the ultimate challenge, the icy terrain. This time, Tesla's electric truck was put to the test to determine its stability and handling when faced with slippery conditions on the possibility of driving. Why is this test so important, you may wonder? Well, it's a clear testament to Tesla's commitment to safety. By pushing the Cybertruck to its limits on the ice, the drivers sought to ascertain whether the truck could regain control from a skid. The question that lingers in the minds of enthusiasts is whether this feat was accomplished by the skillful hands of the driver or through the advanced capabilities of truck's computer system, I mean the full self-driving Tesla's autonomy. The answer to this intriguing mystery will undoubtedly surface in due course. So please subscribe to this channel, because as soon as I know, I'm going to bring you more, and I have another interesting video coming up about Cybertruck. So if you've ever attempted to navigate icy roads, you know how treacherous they can be. Typically, vehicles struggle to maintain control, their tires desperately searching for grip. But as you can see, Cybertruck seems to defy these expectations to a degree, as the videos reveal its impressive handling and stability on the ice. The sight of this slick electric vehicle gracefully gliding across the frozen surface is nothing short of, it's actually pretty awe-inspiring. A keen-eyed Twitter user and Tesla blogger named Cybertruck had an intriguing thought about the testing. He says, "I wonder if they're testing the steer-by-wire /4WS traction control in slippery spots. He says, "Doubtless." Now, his speculation opens up an exciting possibilities regarding the Cybertruck's advanced traction control system and its potential to revolutionize driving dynamics on slippery surface. Now let's address the elephant in the room. The broken tail lights or light bars on most of the Cybertruck's prototypes you have seen. While some may view this as a concern, others wonder whether it's merely a trick of the camera or if the tail lights were intentionally turned off. Either way, one thing is clear. The focus should not solely be on aesthetics. The Cybertruck boasts mind-boggling capabilities that are simply unrivaled. According to a comment made by Jose Stergios on Cybertruck NZ tweet post where this video first appeared, people get hung up on the aesthetics, but this vehicle is obscenely capable. If they get to somehow stretch the wheelbase to accommodate commercial upfits, it will create serious competition for the big three, Stergios says. Friends, it's important to note that Tesla has yet to begin delivering the highly anticipated Cybertruck to car buyers. However, these testing videos serve as a powerful advertisement for the remarkable capabilities of Tesla's futuristic electric truck. With the groundbreaking features, the Cybertruck has the potential to challenge the status quo and disrupt the dominance of traditional automakers. Do you agree with that? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. As we eagerly await more updates from Tesla, and I will bring you on this channel, one thing is for certain. The Cybertruck has proven itself on the ice, effortlessly navigating the treacherous terrain. So what do you think of the Cybertruck's handling on the ice? I would like to hear your thoughts and comments, friends. Share your thoughts, as this electrifying journey is only just beginning. So let's see how Cybertruck does. This is Armin Harayan from TorqueNews.com. If you like this video, please give us thumbs up. I would greatly appreciate it. And let's move on to our next story. Tesla gigapress maker Idra posts Cybertruck diecasting video. Look at this, friends. Tesla gigapress maker Idra has posted a new video of the 9,000-ton Cybertruck diecasting machine in testing operation. This is a huge machine with simple-looking yet sophisticated operations. It will diecast the Cybertruck, Tesla is not joking around. Cybertruck production has been sandbagged. I mean, Tesla has lowered the expectations from Cybertruck. It requires less strength and core competencies in order to produce relatively greater than anticipated result. What I mean by this? Remember, Cybertruck doesn't require any painting. Throughput will be off the chart once the production line and battery supply are dialed in, I think. IDRA is so important that there is a thought in the online community that on Twitter that Tesla should perhaps consider buying IDRA. However, one Twitter blogger named Mike Ball writes that according to his memory, Tesla has tried to purchase IDRA, but the offer was apparently rejected. Do you guys remember anything like this? Please let me know in the comment section below if you think it would be prudent business decision for Tesla to purchase IDRA and make its own die-casting machines known as gigapresses. I mean, look how many IDRA has already supplied to Tesla, and from what I understand, it's already going to supply few to other major car makers, including, if I'm not mistaken, Toyota. So if you look at the image of this giant Cybertruck gigapress, it's hard to have a size perspective, but if you look carefully, you will see that the workbench then that is next to the ladder on the left is about 3.5 feet tall. So this gives you some perspective, I think. This video alone should greatly concern every single automotive CEO on the planet, as it shows how the future cars will be made. This is just wild, I think. The competition has no shot at matching Tesla's production lines in the next 5 years unless they do something really drastic. Here's a question for you guys. I have about the Tesla die casting machine. Once in operation, does the die casting machine stay all nice, clean looking like the or does the die casting machine become a filthy, dirty mess? Having said this, I think the only mess would be the heat from the parts as it is being pulled out. I don't know how they oil the forms, but I would imagine the oil has nearly zero overspray. So I heard Giga Texas was going to be closed for a day a few days ago. I'm now wondering if it's because of the installment of the machine. What do you think? I think this was a day or two ago or in the next couple of days. Anyway, and for your information, this die casting is a manufacturing process that uses high pressure molten metal to create complex parts. This process is used to make a variety of parts for Tesla vehicles, including the body, frame, and suspension components of Tesla vehicles, including Cybertruck, regarding this die casting machine. Die casting is a very efficient manufacturing process, and it can produce parts with high accuracy and repeatability. I mean, repeatedly they can do that. This makes it a good fit for Tesla production needs. The die casting process is also relatively safe, as the molten metal is contained within the die. However, there are some safety risks associated with the process, such as burns from hot metal and exposure to fumes. But I think Tesla can get this done and fixed if, God forbid, these things happen. So this is Armin Haria from TorqueNews.com. Let me know, what do you think about this die casting machine video that Tesla has, IDRA has shown and shared about Cybertruck's die casting? Let me know in the comment section below, friends.